Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sam, and today we will compare the images of fetal brain. These are axial images. This right here is the skull bone. This hyperechoic line is the fox cerebri. And in the posterior fossa, this is the posterior fossa. And this bilob structure is the cerebellum, and it is covered by the cerebellar vermis. And over here, this is a slightly different level, and this is the cavum septi pellucidi. It is an anechoic rectangular structure in front of the thalamus, and these hypoechoic structures are the thalami on either side of the fox cerebri in front of the cerebellum. Our first case is ventriculomegaly. It is the abnormal dilatation of the lateral ventricles. The diameter of the lateral ventricles must be less than 10 millimeters. The choroid plexus normally occupy the majority of the space. They produce cerebrospinal fluid. And over here, the lateral ventricle diameter is more than 10 millimeters. If the diameter is between 10 to 12 millimeters, it is termed as mild ventriculomegaly. And we do not see this area clearly because of the near field reverberation artifact, which occurs due to the skull bone. Because in the upper part of the image, the ultrasound beam has higher energy. So there are large number of reflections in this area. In moderate ventriculomegaly, the size of the lateral ventricles is between 12 to 15 millimeters. As you can see, it is larger as compared to mild ventriculomegaly. In severe ventriculomegaly, the diameter of the lateral ventricles exceeds 15 millimeters. The choroid plexus are hyperechoic structures inside the lateral ventricles. They produce cerebrospinal fluid and occupy most of the space inside the lateral ventricles. In severe ventriculomegaly, a condition known as the dangling choroid plexus occurs. In this, the choroid plexus will be reduced in size and it will appear to float inside the lateral ventricle or dangle. In aqueductal stenosis, the aqueduct of Sylvius, which connects the third ventricle to the fourth ventricle, is obstructed. This leads to dilatation of the third ventricle and the lateral ventricle. The normal third ventricle will have a slit-like appearance, whereas when it is dilated, it will have a rectangular appearance. Hydranencephaly is a rare condition in which the cerebral hemispheres are replaced by large fluid-filled cavities. We do not see any brain tissue over here, with a little bit visualization of the thalami. One way to distinguish between hydranencephaly and sphere hydrocephalus is the presence of some cortical tissue in the case of severe hydrocephalus. Porencephaly is defined as multiple cystic spaces inside the brain. Here we can see four separate cystic spaces. Schizencephaly presents as clefts inside the brain. There are mainly two types, open lip and closed lip. These clefts extend from the lateral ventricles all the way to the subarachnoid space, which means they will be reaching the skull bones on this image. In closed lip schizencephaly, the walls of the cleft are in contact with each other, which means there is no open connection between the cleft that reaches from the lateral ventricle and the subarachnoid space. There is no open connection. In the open lip type, the walls of the clefts have separation and there is direct connection from the lateral ventricle to the brain surface. An arachnoid cyst is present between the meninges of the brain, that is, in the subarachnoid space, and they do not connect with the lateral ventricles. The most common location is the parietal region, but it can also be present in the posterior fossa or the supracellar region. This is an arachnoid cyst present in the parietal region. It is one of the most common locations of arachnoid cyst. A choroid plexus cyst is present inside the choroid plexus. As you know, the choroid plexus are hyperechoic structures. So a cyst inside a choroid plexus will have well-defined echogenic walls. Here is another image of a choroid plexus cyst. It has hyperechoic walls. Holoprosencephaly is a brain disease which has three main types. The first main type is A-lobar holoprosencephaly. In this, the thalami are fused. You can notice here the thalami are fused, whereas in the normal image they are on either side of the fox cerebri. And there is a single ventricle, monoventricular cavity, and the fox cerebri is also absent. This form is also associated with facial abnormalities. One of them is proboscis. In this, an appendage protrudes out from the forehead. This is a sagittal image showing a proboscis, an appendage protruding out, which we can notice in this view. Another facial abnormality is hypotelorism. It is the reduced distance between the orbits or between the eyes. Normally it is around 1.3 centimeter. But in hypotelorism, it will be lesser, and we can see the orbits, the eyes, much closer to each other. In semilobar holoprosencephaly, the ventricles posteriorly are partially separated, but anteriorly they are fused and have a single large monoventricular cavity. As shown in this image, they are not separated, whereas in the normal view they are separated, and the fox cerebri will also be absent. Lobar holoprosencephaly is the least severe form. In this, the thalami are normal, but the cavum, septum, pellucidum is absent. In agenesis of corpus callosum, the corpus callosum, which divides the cerebral hemispheres, is absent. Along with that, the cavum, septum, pellucidum is also absent. One classic sign is colpocephaly, which is the teardrop-shaped lateral ventricle configuration. The ventricles are dilated and they have a teardrop shape as compared to the other types of ventriculomegaly. This one has a different shape. Interhemispheric cyst is present between the cerebral hemispheres in the midline. It occurs due to extension of the third ventricle above the level of the thalami. Anencephaly is a condition in which both calvarium and brain tissues are absent. Calvarium is part of the skull that surrounds the brain, and in anencephaly it is absent along with the brain tissue. The brain tissue is also absent. We cannot see it in anencephaly. Acrania or exencephaly is a condition in which the calvarium is absent but there is presence of abnormal brain tissue. This is the abnormal brain tissue, and this is called angiomatous stroma. When there is a protrusion of brain structures, meninges, and cerebrospinal fluid through a defect or a hole in the calvarium, this condition is called encephalocele. This is the protrusion of brain tissue and some meninges, and over here the defect must be present in this area. Dandy Walker malformation is associated with posterior fossa. There is a defect in the cerebellar vermis, which leads to fluid collection in this area. Here is a sagittal view of Dandy Walker malformation. There is ventriculomegaly as well as posterior fossa fluid collection. In vein of Kaelin malformation, there is aneurysm of this vein, and on Doppler it will show turbulent flow. Right here it has mixing of colors, so it is turbulent flow. Also, this vein is having a larger diameter. Here is another image of vein of Kaelin malformation without Doppler. It has a larger diameter, but the best way to see it is on Doppler. Intracranial tumors are very rare, but when there is a mass seen, it is most likely a hemorrhage. This hemorrhage can appear as hyperechoic structures inside the ventricle or inside the brain tissue. They will have somewhat of a heterogeneous appearance, but mostly they will be hyperechoic. Here they will not look like choroid plexus, they will be heterogeneous as compared to choroid plexus. Intraventricular hemorrhage can cause inflammation of the lateral ventricles, which will lead to their walls appearing hyperechoic, and the choroid plexus will appear larger and have a lumpy appearance due to blood. Here is a coronal view of intraventricular hemorrhage showing hyperechoic walls of the lateral ventricles. CMV infections or infections from cytomegalovirus can occur in fetal brain. They present as calcifications in the brain tissue. Here you can see small calcifications. So when you notice such calcifications, it can be a CMV infection. Here is another example in axial view, showing small calcifications in a CMV infection. Chiari2 malformation is associated with the shape of the skull and shape of the cerebellum. The skull resembles the shape of a lemon because of flattening of the frontal bones. This is why it's called the lemon sign. Another sign is called the banana sign. This one is associated with the shape of the cerebellum. You can see the cerebellum is shaped like a banana. It is bent facing forward. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and stay tuned for more imaging videos.